Hi there, and welcome back for some more training on Solidworks. Today we're going to be talking about the fundamental building block of three-dimensional objects in Solidworks, and that's the extrude command. I'm going to go ahead and open up a new part document here. And in the graphics area, I'll go ahead and select the front plane and open a sketch. Now you'll recall from sketching, we want to make sure that all of our sketches are fully defined, and in this tutorial, I'm going to just build a simple little bracket. All right, and I can do that by just sketching away here. Notice as I sketch, you can see that if I draw a line that's close to horizontal, the line has a sketch relationship put on it of being horizontal. And then when it's finally time to actually close my sketch, if I mouse right over the origin again, it will put a constraint on the end of my line that it be on the origin. So you can see that I have two fully defined lines based on where they start and the direction they head in, and now I need to do my best to add a few relations to fully define this. I'll do that quickly here. I'm going to set that these two lines need to be collinear, meaning that if I move this one, the other one moves with it. I'm also going to set a relation that they be equal in length so that the what that does is it makes it so that if I adjust them, this center area always will be remain in the center. All right, I'll throw some dimensions on. I'm going to want this to be 6 inches, and maybe make this guy 4 inches, and we should make these guys, oops, somehow I didn't get these collinear. There we go. And then let's do 2 and 2 here. 2 inches and 2 inches. All right, so my sketch is fully defined. We can see that by the fact that it's all black, and down in the bottom corner it says fully defined. Now, I have a two-dimensional sketch that I want to turn into a 3D object. So I come up to my command manager and I click on extrude boss base. Over here in the feature manager, you can see there's a bunch of settings I can choose. Let's go ahead, and for now, I'm fine with a blind extrusion. This is what's called the end condition. So you can see there's several options. For now, we'll just do blind, since this is the first extrusion we're doing in our part. The two arrow button here next to the end condition switches the direction. Hard to see here, but let me change this. I'm going to make my bracket 4 inches deep. And now if I switch the direction, you can see that it says, do I extrude this back away from us or do I pull it towards us? We're going to go ahead and just check that, and we have our first three-dimensional object here. All right, so we have a simple U bracket. There's lots more to extrusion, though, than just that simple blind extrusion. Let me give you some examples. I'm going to open up a new sketch here, and I'm going to draw a circle. Okay, I'll locate that circle right about there, and put on, select my midpoint, make that vertical so it's fixed now to be in the middle, right? And I'll put a dimension that it needs to be 1 inch off of the edge, and another dimension for its diameter, and let's make it just a 1 inch hole. All right, now I'm going to go ahead and extrude that, and it depends on what I want to do here. If I want to build just a shaft that comes out of my block, I can use my blind extrusion. However, it might be that I don't want to do that. I actually want to do a thin feature. Do you see the difference there? Now, instead of extruding a solid shaft, I'm extruding this circular sketch, and I'm giving it some thickness in the thin feature. Again, the thin feature has lots of settings we can set. You can set one direction, mid-plane, or two directions. Okay, let's go back. One direction, if I flip the direction, you can see it says, do I extrude this with a thickness of 0.1 inch on the inside or the outside of that circle? Okay, so extruding a thin feature is very handy. All we have to do is draw the outline and we can extrude that guy. I'm going to go ahead and thicken this up a little bit and say check. So now we have this shaft that sticks out here. Another very handy feature of extrusions is playing with that end condition. I'm going to go ahead and open up a sketch on this wall here. Again, I select the face, and then in the flyout toolbar, I select open sketch. And again, I'm going to go ahead and draw a simple sketch here. I'll just make it a straight line, okay? And I should go ahead and fully define that line. So let's select the midpoint and let's set a distance actually. We'll just dimension this guy instead of doing relations. We'll say it's 1 inch and that it starts 1.5 inches from the end and it is 1 inch from the bottom. All right, so I have a fully defined line sketch there. And if I go ahead and extrude, it knows, since I haven't closed the profile, that I'm just going to be extruding a single line. And you can see it's doing one side. I could change that to be mid-plane so that it sandwiches that line with a quarter inch of material. And you can see that it's pushing it. We're still using our blind in condition, right? So it's coming blindly out some distance, in this case 4 inches. However, maybe I don't want it to do that. Maybe I just want it to go up to the surface. I can change my in condition and say up to surface, and then it highlights this blue box over here and says, what surface would you like me to go up to? If I select here, you can see it gives me a preview. It just extrudes across there. I could instead select this face, and you can see it extrudes all the way through. I could even select over here, and you'll see that the extrusion switches direction and goes towards that face. Very handy for when you're trying to just extrude a particular distance. Okay. What are some other end conditions? I could say up to next, and this says it's going to go until it hits the next surface, not a particular surface that you select, but just up to the very next one. Up to a vertex, I could select a vertex that I want it to hit. So I want it to go up to this point, and it will go until it hits that point in that direction. Okay. We can do offset from surface. This is very handy. Maybe I want to make a diving board, and I only want it to be 1 inch from that surface. Okay, so now I've made it so that this extrusion comes out from this wall until it's within 1 inch of here. Another very handy end condition. All right, I'm going to go ahead and hit check here. There's lots to do with extrusions, and in our next video, we'll talk about extruding cuts. A very similar process, but instead of adding material, we'll be removing material. That's all for now.